This is the town of Quebradillas. And like a lot of other places in Puerto Rico, it has beautiful views. But it was sort of a hidden gem, a small and lesser known town by non-Puerto Ricans. But some locals say that's changing.
Vienen esta gente de otros países americanos y ven todo esto y enseguida lo que le viene es dollar signs, como dice, dollar signs en la mente. I'm packing here, this is the next place I'm packing.
Now some Puerto Ricans are having to pack their bags and move out.
Nos están sacando de nuestro lugar. Cuando abramos nuestros ojos no vamos a tener isla y vamos a ser un Puerto Rico sin puertorriqueños.
And as more Puerto Ricans are feeling displaced, tensions are rising.
O sea, si tú eres un colonizador, porque eso es lo que está pasando, están comprando nuestras tierras, están comprando nuestras casas, que se vayan. Punto. O sea, es que no, uno, que no venga, dos, que te vaya.
I'm starting this video with the story of this building, an 18-unit apartment complex in Quebradillas with an ocean view.
Esto es el sueño que yo siempre quería, tener un apartamento así.
Brenda Velázquez loves her two-bedroom apartment.
What's your favorite part?
My bedroom. Because I have a lounge chair in the balcony. Sometimes, you know, the electricity goes out, I sit out there. I just love it here. I want to spend the rest of my life here.
That was your plan.
That was my plan. Yo dije, de aquí, perdonando la expresión, me sacan con las patas para el frente, porque esto es, ya según tú lo ves, es tranquilo, nos llevamos todo bien.
But then rumors started that a tenant who was living in the penthouse had bought the building.
I guess since he moved up there, he had that in mind since he was looking at the ocean view that we have from the beginning. I think he already had in mind, well, I could convert this into more money.
Finally, one of the neighbors asked him.
Le digo, mira, tú compraste esto aquí, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Me dice, I don't want to dampen anybody's holidays, but I'm going to make a new project here, and all of you's got to move.
And then the letter came, telling residents that the San Jose Hills apartment building had sold, that it would be remodeled, and that everyone would have to leave by December 31st. Some tenants say they received the letter the weekend before Thanksgiving.
It was terrible. That's the worst news. You know, when I came there, I started crying because I said, I can't believe this, that we got to move from here. And it still hurts, it still hurts. But there's nothing we can do, it really hurts.
Estamos, unos días estamos con mucha tensión, otros días no podemos dormir, ansiosos todo el tiempo, porque de repente nos hemos tenido que dar a la tarea de comenzar a buscar un lugar donde vivir.
Yanira Ocasio and her husband moved to San Jose Hills a year and a half ago.
Un lugar muy, muy tranquilo, el sentido de comunidad. Es como una comunidad pequeña y estamos todos pendientes los unos de los otros.
They had no plans to move out anytime soon until they got the news.
Nos han informado que van a hacer un tipo club, un high-end Airbnb o hotel, tipo club, para aparentemente dedicado a los residentes de Estados Unidos.
¿Y por qué hace así? ¿Qué le parece eso?
Me indigna que nos siguen sacando de nuestro Puerto Rico, de nuestra tierra.
The new owner called a meeting with all the tenants about a week after sending them the letter.
Nos dijo que estábamos pagando por debajo del precio, que esto realmente costaba mucho más que eso.
This is ridiculous, fue lo que dijo. And the apartments you got, you know how much they would cost in San Juan? Y yo con Ana decirle, yeah, but that's San Juan. This is Quebradilla, esto es un pueblo chiquito.
I just had no idea that there were people in there paying $600. It's wild.
Giovanni Ferrosi is the person behind 51 Club Quebradillas, the newly formed limited liability company that now owns San Jose Hills.
I mean, the building is it's a gated community with parking. It has amenities, has a pool, tennis courts, the very large units. Six of them have full rooftop decks. I don't know of literally anywhere. And I'm Italian. I don't think I go to Italy and find anything like this. It's wild.
Ferrosi was a state senator in Rhode Island for the Republican Party, He ran for governor of the state, but lost in the primary. He then moved to Puerto Rico and became a resident in 2019. He also registered under Act 22, now part of Act 60, which allows newcomers to pay zero capital gains tax when they move to Puerto Rico. Ferosi is also the number two personal income tax delinquent, according to the state of Rhode Island, owing more than $1.2 million.
Yeah, it's only $500,000 in change. All the rest are the penalties that they created, but with the misreporting.
But to be clear, you do owe the state of Rhode Island tax money. You're just saying that number is not accurate.
Correct. That's correct.
You know, one of the things I really appreciate about Cape Verdeas is it's a beautiful little town, but everyone here is it's still like, you know, the olden days. You go to church, it's packed.
When Ferosi moved to Puerto Rico, he first rented an apartment in the San Juan area, but then he visited Quebradillas and decided to stay.
It was kind of a no-brainer for me to pay $1,100 to have the apartment I have now compared to what I was paying in Condado.
Ferosi says he's been wanting to buy the building since he moved in.
I just thought it was a gorgeous building and it had a lot of opportunity.
He bought the building through his company for $1.8 million in August. But in June, a couple months before it was official, he posted a video to Instagram announcing that he was doing a pre-sale of the units.
You know, after that, prices are going to go up dramatically.
He says he got in trouble with the realtor for that.
Man, they just came. They said, don't you say that. You don't own it yet. You don't. I said, okay. Why don't you want to tell people what's coming? It's weird. So I got to be honest with you. The only people who were stopping you from getting any information were literally other Puerto Rican people trying to like tell me not to be nice.
This wonderful complex is going to become a brand, and we're going to make it really cool.
First, he thought about turning the apartments into condos, but Ferosi says he's also thinking about turning the building into a hotel. If he does, he says he would be creating jobs.
Puerto Rico's number one opportunity to change its economic condition is through increasing tourism. So if you increase tourism, everything else will come in.
I asked Ferosi for his response to the residents who say they're being displaced by outsiders. And he had two things to say.
I'm not an outsider. I live in Quebradillas, man. I mean, I'm Puerto Rican now. I lived there this is my fourth year.
That he's from Quebradillas now?
I think the word displaced is momentary, maybe.
And that getting displaced now would pay off later for residents.
The potential momentary feeling should be not only mitigated, but it would go away as you see more opportunities grow. We all have to be in this together. That includes, you know, the residents, you know, everybody. So I love Quebradillas. And for me, I think it needs a hotel.
Meanwhile, tenants like Janita are having a hard time finding a place to live. She and her husband are now suing Ferosi, alleging he's discriminating against the current tenants to offer the apartments to non-Puerto Rico residents and or to people of a higher social class.
Es totalmente una injusticia.
Why did you make the decision to ask them to leave as opposed to being the new owner of this building and continuing to have the current tenants?
Yeah, I didn't buy the project to own an apartment building. That wasn't like the original intent.
Ferosi also says the rent that the current tenants are paying is too low to upkeep the building. The lowest rent at San Jose Hills was $600 a month. But according to the 2019 census, that's above the median rent in Quebradillas, which is a little over $450 a month, in a town where the median household income is around $17,000.
No puede ser que estas amenidades se conviertan en privilegio.
Raúl Santiago Bartolomé studies gentrification. He says in some towns in Puerto Rico, lower income people are getting priced out of the neighborhoods where they need to be in order to have access to jobs and services.
What you're doing really is moving poverty around. You're not reducing poverty in the area, you're just pushing it around.
This is a really popular place that has a lot of Airbnbs.
Short-term rentals are also taking over. Santiago Bartolomé created this map with all the Airbnbs in Puerto Rico between 2014 and 2020. He says the more Airbnbs, the fewer housing options for local residents.
It makes housing more expensive for long-term residents, but at the same time, it's attractive for investors and property owners because it provides a way to make a quick buck, so to say, a lot quicker than renting them in the long-term rental market.
That's attracting investors to buy multiple properties in Puerto Rico to then rent them out on Airbnb. In his study, Santiago Bartolomé found that just 10 hosts had a combined total of more than 600 properties listed, making almost $18 million in 1 year.
Whatever money is accrued stays mainly with the property owner. And very, 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 very little actually trickles out to the rest of the community.
So all these houses you can get for super cheap, and you're people are starting to figure that out.
This is Diane Cohn's YouTube channel.
He's gonna show us all the hot places today.
She moved to Puerto Rico in 2014.
Pretty much it was a combination of midlife crisis and tax benefits.
She also got a tax break under Act 22. She moved back to the States shortly after Hurricane Maria, but she has continued to make videos about her experience in Puerto Rico.
Every once in a while, I'd come back to Puerto Rico just because that's what the algorithm rewarded me for. Because every time I did something in Puerto Rico, I'd get views and subscribers and comments and all the interaction that any creator wants on their channel.
Wow, look at this beach.
A few months ago, she posted a video that received backlash in the comment section.
It was kind of a punch to the gut. You know, I'm like, wow, people are really upset, you know, and I was thinking, well, this was not my intention. You know, it's not my intention to exploit Puerto Rico. But, you know, it's not something I really thought about either until they pointed out that point of view. You know, I mean, to get in a car with a realtor and to drive around and just say, hey, where are the good deals? Where's the opportunity? I mean, that's just, I don't know. That's just how people look at real estate.
And this is when you want to buy.
Right.
This is when it looks like this.
In the video, she talked about the real estate opportunities in Isabela, the town next to Quebradillas.
We're the best kept secrets in Puerto Rico. But the secret is getting out.
Not anymore.
Si no te cucamona, tengo la personalidad. La tengo, la tengo.
Isabela is also the town where Suset Quiroz was living with her partner and newborn baby. But when the landlord where she was renting was moving back into the house, they had a hard time finding another place they could afford.
Cuando iba a ver casas o apartamentos, en un momento dado hablé con un realtor que me dijo, sí, nosotros preferimos alquilarle a gringos porque no, o sea, el proceso es mucho más fácil y nos dan el dinero bien rápido. Le ofrecían más a los dueños de las casas. Ah, tu anuncio está en tanto, yo te doy más y te adelanto 6 meses de renta. Porque tenían ese poder adquisitivo, tienen ese poder adquisitivo, tienen más dinero, vienen con un sueldo mucho más alto.
They ended up having to move to the next town over, Aguadilla.
I'm gonna show you where the next hot spot is gonna be for Aguadilla.
Suzette says she came across Diane's Isabela video.
That is incredible.
But couldn't get through the whole thing.
Guiar por una calle donde yo pasaba todos los días y escuchar a un gringo decir, sí, porque yo me mudé aquí justo después del huracán María. Y pensar en todas las personas que se tuvieron que ir de Puerto Rico después del huracán María. De todas las personas que murieron en Puerto Rico después del huracán María. Por eso yo no seguí viendo el video.
Diane made a video in response to the backlash.
Am I a colonizer? Do the people of Puerto Rico really prefer their abandoned buildings? Do they like seeing empty businesses and trash everywhere?
As islanders, why not take advantage of your inside contacts, snag the best real estate deals yourself, fix them up, and sell them at a profit to people you like?
No es que yo no trabajo duro y por eso no puedo comprar una propiedad. Es el problema. Que aunque trabajas duro, no te la puedes comprar.
I empathize with that, but that's also just kind of how the world is. I mean, it sounds terrible, but it's just how the world is. And so you have to do the best you can to kind of, you know, get ahead, get onto the ladder, get ahead on the ladder.
Yo me estoy defendiendo. El que yo no quiera que esa gente se mude a Puerto Rico no es porque no me caen bien o porque no me gusta la gente blanca o la gente rubia o tengo un problema con la gente que habla inglés. Se trata de que tú me estás afectando mi vida.
It is a problem, I understand it. What's the solution? You know, you have the politicians that are inviting investors.
Hay entidades que se están dedicando a la transformación de espacios en desuso. Hay un trabajo que se está haciendo y que podemos hacer nosotros los puertorriqueños y no tenemos que esperar a que nadie del extranjero venga a hacerlo por nosotros.
The island holds a special place in my heart. You know, we were there for 4 years. We drove all over those mountains. We explored so much and yeah, it's a beautiful place. I don't know, I'm crying, I guess because I care.
I always loved, you know, to have an apartment with ocean view, and I got it here.
But now I lost it. Now it's lost.
Meanwhile, Brenda still hasn't found a place to move to.
Most of the apartments and houses here in this town, in Quebradillas, they're all becoming Airbnb. Most of them. I can't find a house.
The new owner told me he's now giving tenants until March to move out.
My daughter comes to see me. She said, Ma, it's a damn shame. You gotta leave this place. I said, it's not my choice, sweetie. It's not my choice. She loves this place. She really loved this place.